in all governments, Ministry of Foreign Affairs number is the two. Number A1 ministry, following the presidency.
Yeah.
For the presidency. But in Uganda, Ministry of Foreign Affairs is just one of those to whom you may concern. It's sometimes embarrassing that we it's because we are cadres and you know you just accept your deployment and you don't question the deployment and you move on.
These were the lamentations of Okello Oryem, the acting minister for foreign affairs. Oryem, together with finance minister Maria Kiwanuka and officials from other ministries, were appearing before the budget committee of parliament to defend a supplementary budget. Besides Uganda's dilapidated structures abroad and poorly facilitated ambassadors, Oryem told MPs that even the hotels he can afford to pay for while negotiating for the country are embarrassing and leave a lot to be desired.
But the hotel, the mere Minister of Foreign Affairs lives in, my friend, is downtown in Queens.
Wow.
Like, go cool, my friend. This is the Minister of Foreign Affairs. In the evening, my friend says, let us meet at the Waldorf place for consultation. I pretend I'm sitting in the lounge with the Waldorf with them. I pretend I'm staying up there. When time comes, I say, excuse me, go to the toilet. I'm going to my book. No, really. Uganda.
The MPs seemed amused, but the minister was clear and unfazed with his words. He retaliated that he travels like a common person and is driven in an old car.
My car, I'm driving the car, I'm driving, he's 7 years old. 7 years old. Your Minister of Foreign Affairs is driving a car when you're 7 years old. And you hear creaky, 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 we're going with the man. When I fly to the General Assembly, we normally converge at Heathrow Airport with my colleagues from ministers from other places. We had the business lounge, you know, big people. Then when we enter the plane, I'm alone in the business class. Where are the others? Are they third class? No. Where? They're in the first class. They continue consulting. Me, I'm here.
You are in the business class.
To enable him to perform his duties, Oryem is demanding for enough facilitation.
I'm not begging anything more than what is due. Give us exactly what is within our ceiling. We will, like others, tighten our belt and work within our ceiling. We're not asking for more.
He told lawmakers that when he travels abroad, he is treated as a high-profile delegate and high-class facilities by his counterparts. But he has nothing to offer when they visit him in Uganda because of lack of money. Agnes Nandutu, NTV, Parliament.